in a couple of days. It's going to be 1 year ever since I moved to Japan. So I thought it wise to make a video about the mistakes I've made ever since I moved to Japan. And I must admit the mistakes there a lot. I made a lot of mistakes, and some of them were due to the cultural difference and some were because of the language barrier. I'm here with George. George, say hi. He's busy watching animations. So to begin, one of the mistakes I made, I would say this mistake is because of the cultural difference, is entering the house with shoes. I was going to see the apartment where we would be staying, and I entered the house with shoes. Yeah, that was because I just forgot about that fact. And I've done that not only at the apartment, but in also my mother-in-law's house. The second mistake I ever made in Japan was how to talk to people. So in Malawi, when talking to a friend, it's very normal to point at finger, like iwe, like that. So I noticed in Japan, I came to Japan and I did the same, talking to people. Like when addressing someone, you say this one, you point, use index finger to point at someone, which I didn't notice it. It's very wrong in Japan, but in Malawi, it's very, very normal. After some time, I noticed that in Japan, people use the ho palm when talking about someone, like talking to you, like this. Yeah, so after I learned that, I was pretty embarrassed that I was rude unknowingly. The other thing is about taking a bath. So first of all, let me show you how I used to take a bath in Malawi. As shown in the clip, it's very common to use one bucket individually, especially in rural areas, one bucket of water individually to take a bath. But I came to Japan. I was really shocked to see people taking bath and using the same water in the same bathtub. The other mistake I made, this other day I went to my mother-in-law's house. Yeah, I stayed overnight, so I had to take a bath. And I went to the shower room and I saw a lot of water in the bathtub, and the water was hot and covered in hot. And I thought I could use that water. And I entered the bathtub and showered, cleaned myself, showered. And after I finished taking a bath, I was thinking to myself, this water is too much, what should I do? Then I just said, because I've used this water, it's dirty, it has soap, I think I have to dispose it, and I threw the water away. Only to be told later that people use the same water, like the next person to take a bath should use the same water. That really shocked me. Because in Malawi, people use individual buckets. People in Malawi use one bucket per person to take a bath. Yeah, for adults, just one bucket, not like using the same water to take a bath. really embarrassed about that situation. Yeah. So since that day, I opt to take a shower than using a bathtub. On the same note, I got mad at Leo, my son, for taking a bath with adults. In Malawi, it's totally unacceptable for children to take a bath with adults. I noticed that the other day Leon went to take a bath with grandpa, my father-in-law, Leon and George. They took bath together, and when they came out, I was really mad at Leon. I asked him, "What are you doing?" Because in Malawi, it's considered very rude for kids to take a bath with adults. After some time, I noticed that this is the normal culture in Japan, like children taking bath with adults. I also learned that taking a bath with grandpa, father, adults is like a way of bonding, a way of communication, and they really do have fun. I've never experienced that, and I'm sure it cannot happen in Malawi for a child to take a bath with grandfather or a father. I do regret for getting mad at Leon, because I never knew that this is the normal culture. I think Leon learned quickly than me the fact that this is very normal. The other mistake I made is because of the language barrier. I was excited to learn Japanese language when I first came here, but when I noticed that I'm making a lot of mistakes, and this particular mistake made me made my self-esteem to be low, my morale of learning Japanese to be very low, because I was really embarrassed. Whenever we go out with George and Leon, people say kawaii, kawaii, and I learned that that word means cute or pretty. So I noted that way. It's a way of appreciating someone. And at some point of time, I tried to appreciate someone, kawaii, but I was told I said it in a wrong way. I said, why? Why? Yeah, which is very wrong, they say. Well, I was taught it's a quite different way. So I was really embarrassed about that. So I went to a supermarket, and I was really happy to find small fish. Yeah. Small fish is very common in Malawi. We have so many different types of small fish, and I like small fish as well. So I saw small fish without knowing, without reading, without being cautious of what section it was. I bought a packet of small fish, and when I came home, I showed my husband. I was really excited. I bought this packet of fish. And I was also embarrassed to learn that put the fish from a pet section. Yeah, so I was like, how can a pet have this kind of good food? That was really quite embarrassing for me, right? Because I didn't read and I didn't check. I bought fish from a pet section. If I didn't show my husband, I think I could cook and eat. So the other thing is about dressing. I learned this from the comments. I didn't know that I was making a mistake. I learned this from one of videos, this video. So someone commented like, Jen is wearing a heat tech. Yeah, first of all, I didn't know that there are specific clothes for specific seasons in Japan, specifically what I was wearing that day, heat tech, they call it. So that takes me to the fashion in Japan. In Japan, I've never seen like people, women especially, wearing clothes that expose their upper part of body, like bare back and showing the chest more. But it's quite common to see some women wearing short skirts or bum shorts, which is very, very different from Malawi. In some areas in Malawi, especially rural areas, I think it's very uncommon to see a woman wearing a miniskirt, especially in rural areas. Like I said, people will embarrass you for wearing like that. But because Malawi is hot, Malawi is a hot country, women wear clothes that show their upper skin more, like short sleeve. So the mistake I made was to bring some of my clothes in Japan, summer clothes, because Malawi is hot. I brought summer clothes in Japan, but I ended up just packing them because of the different way of dressing between Malawi and Japan. I couldn't wear them. Like in Malawi, I used to wear like just one string and go out, but I don't think I can do that in Japan. First, because Japan is very cold than Malawi, and secondly, because women don't wear like that in Japan. I made quite a lot of mistakes. I just wish I could share with you these mistakes I talked about. Thank you for the comments. I do not only learn from people, I also learn from the comments what to do and what not to do, what to wear or what not to wear, like that. So thank you for watching this video. See you in my next video. Bye.